Take one, two, three.
This is Robert S. Womack. You remember my name?
Lauren. How you doing?
How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
We're here for healthcare because we believe we are in it together. And I'm a patient, chronic migraines, and this guy's fighting for my rights right here in Grand Rapids, Kent County.
And Lauren, thanks for putting this together. She put this wonderful event together. We all came out to support and to make sure we're standing with millions and millions of more Americans across the United States, standing up for health care, the Affordable Care Act, letting people know that pre-existing conditions like Lauren has to be protected. So I come out every night if we had this every night because it's that important.
We can't live without healthcare, and we can't live without the support of one another. This is not just partisan. It's not just Democrat or Republican. Was it you that said that? No, it was Winnie Brinks.
Winnie Brinks.
The speakers tonight have our interests at heart, and they come out to support us. They do their jobs to speak up for us, and it's in our votes that we can stand up for one another. It takes every single one of us to get out here to tell our stories, to connect with one another, to reach across the divides that we all have, and to connect, to see each other as human beings, frailty that we all have, and as it is exemplified in this atrocious bill that we must defeat.
We must defeat it. Because we don't want to look up 36 months from now and you're at a funeral of somebody who would be alive and be here if we had been proactive right now to stop what they're trying to do to the Affordable Care Act. This is real important. When Lauren spoke, she really brought it home because it actually affects her life. It affects lots of our relatives. And I'm glad you were the first speaker because you really set the tone tonight.
I'm glad you took over because I would have kept crying.
Yeah, well.
You were talking about Medicaid. I mean, Medicaid, I don't think very many of us realize what the statistics are on that and how this block grant, once it runs out, we are our elderly.
Yeah, our elderly, seniors, children, disabled, pregnant mothers. So many people are going to be affected by the cuts to Medicaid.
50% of all births in this country are paid for by Medicaid. 50%. Children who are disabled, old people when they die. What happens now when people go bankrupt? They end up in nursing homes and they're covered by Medicaid. They're covered. These are not just entitlements. They're not just people freeloading. They're people who will die in the streets. What will happen to them? Yeah. How can we do this?
And one of the things I mentioned that while we're fighting for health care for Americans, you know, we have an executive office, in the executive office, a man that's giving tax breaks to the 1%. So when he comes and say, hey, we can't afford to do this anymore, we can't afford to do this, but he can afford to give his friends tax breaks. So I had to bring that up tonight. I don't like to make it political because healthcare to me should not be a political issue when so many countries in Europe, they have universal healthcare. Here, we've just done some things that make it a lot easier for people to get insurance, and now they even want to take that.
Well, and I think we can unite around a common goal here, because it's not just that we want to defeat something. We're not just fighting against something. We're
right.
Fighting for something.
Right.
We're fighting for one another. We're fighting for our health. And this is a right. This isn't just a battle against someone or something. This is a battle for each other, for American values, for human values, for human goodness, human kindness, and love. That's American.
We have to end it on that, because after she said that, what else could we say?
Thank you, Robert.
Stay active, and thank
Stay
you for
engaged.
Doing this great event.
Thank you.
Thanks for letting me be a part of it.
Oh, man, you're a powerhouse.